It will fixate on the scan abutments, the height of the restoration that I want, and you still see the scan abutments on the screen.
Hi, and welcome back to Uniqa Dental Show, where we discuss interesting cases and new procedures in the field of dentistry. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and follow us to stay tuned. With us today, as always, is Dr. Yanil. Hi.
Hi, how are you doing?
Amazing, how are you?
Can be better.
Can be better yeah. In this year. Wow, good to hear, okay.
Everything depends on the last year. Now it's 2021, so it will be better.
I like your thinking. What did you bring for us today?
Something very interesting. Today we want to show a case where we did an immediate loading on implants on the lower jaw. Cross arch bridge, 16 crowns, you know, everything. In this photo, you can see that using intraoral scanner is gonna be hard job because you can see all the soft tissue around the healing caps. And you can see that the soft tissue is movable. It's not rigid. So when you're scanning, if you want to insert scan abutments in the places of the implants, you'll have a hard time. You want to enjoy the process. Because every time if you want to move from this kind of abutment to this kind of abutment, the gingiva will move a little bit, and the end product that you'll get at the end result won't be as precise as it's supposed to be.
This problems from even the previous cases that we saw, it mostly occurs on the lower jaw.
Yeah, because in the lower jaw you have the tongue, and you can see this patient has a very large tongue. He didn't have his lower teeth for quite some while. And right now, when you don't have the teeth, the tongue getting larger. So in this case, yeah.
Really?
Yeah, when you don't have teeth, the tongue will be larger.
The tongue itself?
Yeah.
No, I know that the bone, there is a bone absorption, but the tongue gets larger.
Yeah, the tongue gets larger. So the tongue is very large. You can see that when we place the implants, there is no place for the tongue. You always have the tongue in the scanning process. And you have all the movable gingiva around the implants. So if you put just scan abutments and you'll scan around the scan abutments, you'll get always different kind of texture. Different kind of the scan abutment will see different things.
The intraoral scan can fixate on the points.
Yeah, it will fixate on the scan abutments, but between two scan abutments, you have some gingiva. And this gingiva will always move a little bit. And in this case, it will be very, very hard, almost impossible to scan those implants without any different type of methods or help.
Many deviations because of the movement.
Exactly. On the lower jaw, we had implants. About on the implant, we placed metal caps, and about 3 days after the implantation, we placed the bridge. The scan process was done immediately after placing the implants. So you'll have saliva, blood, movable gingiva, tongue, everything in the
one big package of fun.
Yeah, one big package of fun in the scan.
This is after the 3 days, right?
No. It's immediately after the...
It's immediately after the implantation?
Yeah, you can see you don't have even blood clots. Everything's fresh. You have, all in all, 6 implants.
This is after the 3 days?
Yeah, this is after 3 days. You can see you have a little bit of fibrin, blood clots. Everything is not bleeding that much. Right now, it's a little bit easier to scan. So we've waited about 3 days, and now we'll change the scan abutments now we'll change the healing caps to scan abutments. You saw previously the multi-units that we placed right after the surgery. We placed the multi-unit and the scan abutment on the multi-unit. On the multi-unit then, we took off the healing caps and we changed them to scan abutments. Now you can see 6 scan abutments. You can see that because it was done 3 days after the surgery, you don't have this large amount of blood. So you can, it will be a little bit easier.
It's all multi-unit level scan abutment.
Yeah, it's all multi-unit level scan abutment. All the implants are parallel. It's not very difficult case if you're looking in the process of the in the angulation of the implants. But the most difficult part in here is the impression taking. Mm-hmm. If you want to take impression with, for example, open tray with the transfers, also it's very difficult because he has a very large tongue. You need to open his mouth very large. It's a problematic case to take impressions to.
I see, and bone absorption here.
Yeah, a little bit worse bone absorption. He didn't have his lower teeth for quite some time. There was no extraction at the time of placing the implants. So you don't see the sockets of the teeth. He didn't have teeth at all. Now, what we chose to do is to connect all the scan abutments with the composite material, the yellow material that you see, it's light curing composite. Mm-hmm. We connected all the scan abutments, and this way, when we scan, we have one rigid like bar that connects all the implants. Mm-hmm. The scan abutments themselves, when I'll model the teeth, I can use the part of the scan abutment, mm-hmm. but when I'm scanning the whole part, the whole bar, the whole assembly of the scan abutment, the composite material. So this way, the scanner always have a rigid part to connect the next shot to.
So it basically makes the jaw, it holds the jaw together for your scan.
Yeah, it connects all the scan abutments. Now, when I'm using this type of composite material, the next thing I want to do is I want to take relations. I want to know the height of the restoration that I want. And I can know these relations or fix those relations using this composite material also. Because the first scan that I'll want to have is the scan of the scan abutments like this. And this way I can scan the scan abutments from all around. And I have the scan abutments and the composite material and a little bit of the gingiva. Yeah. So my technician knows where the gingiva is. Mm-hmm. My technician knows where the scan abutment is. And you don't have a lot of composite material that interfering with the scan abutments. Now, the second part that I want to do is I want to have relations between the lower and the upper jaw, the mandible and the maxilla. So in the second stage, I'll add composite material. And I'll cure the composite material in the right position of the lower jaw.
Mm-hmm. So we will get the relations between the upper and the lower
jaw. Exactly. So this way, I'll get the relations. I can scan second time, and I can connect the two scans. The first scan with small part of the composite material, with the scan abutments. And the second scan with a lot of composite material and without the gingiva and everything else, but in the right relations.
So we're putting a lot of composite, and because it's soft, before you harden it, you ask the patient to close the mouth and then you harden the material? Or you harden the material and then he's closing the mouth?
I need a few dots in the right relations. I put a composite and light cure the material, and then I just add material to close all the other gaps.
Oh, when he closes
the mouth. Enclosed the mouth in right relations. This way I'll get, it's not ensuring that the first provisional bridge will be perfect, but I know that my first provisional bridge will be close to perfect or close to what it needs to be.
In the closest relations as possible.
Yeah. In here you can see the process when we apply composite material between the scan abutments and we light cure it right away because we want just to save time. You have some time before the material hardens in the syringe itself. So the assistant is light curing and the doctor is applying the composite material.
And this is a procedure, this technique can be, any doctor can do it.
Yeah, you can do
like
it.
Like it's only practice.
Yeah, you can do it also not with the composite material, but with a different kind of acrylics or something like this. But with composite material, it's very comfortable. You can do it very fast and the chair time that you have shortens by quite amount of time.
And it's something that this procedure, like using light curing composite and all these materials, it's something that it's like it's in the latest, like latest years, doctors started using it.
Yeah, because not right now you have a problem with the scanners. With the intraoral scanners, yes. This video is real time. We didn't make it any faster or something. Now it's even a little bit slower. but what we want to show is the whole process takes about 1 minute.
But you save chair time for at least half an hour.
And this is while we're filming it. Mm-hmm. So it takes a lot of time because you have a camera, you have a doctor that doesn't see what happens inside the mouth, and you have an assistant that doesn't see also what happens in the mouth, and you need to open a mouth opener, and you need all the crew to make this video. Mm-hmm. When you only the doctor and the assistant, it's much easier, much simpler. It takes even less time.
And this is, from what I see, it's a full jaw, so it's even harder. Most of the time that you use light curing composite, it's half a jaw less, right? So it's even faster.
Yeah, but when you're using this technique, in many cases it's because it's a very difficult case. You, from the start, you know that you'll have problems. Mm-hmm. So in here we know that we'll have problems, and we just, in the first place, using it, we're not even trying to do anything else.
Experience.
So yeah, that's why we did it. Now, I want to show you, this is the second scan, when you already have the occlusion. I want to show you not how the doctor is scanning inside the mouth, but what we see on the screen. In here you'll see the speed of the scanning, and you still see the scan abutments on the screen.
So this is what the doctor sees on the screen?
Yeah, this is what the doctor sees. You can see some part of the gingiva. Mm-hmm. You can see the scan abutments. And what you scan is the composite material with the scan abutments. Mm-hmm. Then, using the scan abutments, you can find the right position of the implants.
Oh, I see.
Yeah. Even now it's a little bit hard because first of all, you have a beard and it takes a lot of time, and you need to connect all the dots and you need to scan from all the angles.
But without the light curing composite, it would be much harder.
Yeah, because you can't skip from one scan abutment to another.
Ah, this
in here we can see the composite material and the relations of his mouth. Mm-hmm. When he closes the mouth, you can see that it closes always in the same relations. So this is how I can be sure that I have some relations. Maybe these relations are incorrect. Mm-hmm. Maybe for the final bridge, it will be not the relations that I want. But from this relation, I first of all can make a provisional bridge. I know approximately the relation that will be. Maybe the crown height will be too hard to mill, or I'll have different type of consideration that I want to change the relations. But I need something to start with, some kind of primary relations for the first provisional bridge. This is how we're making them. Now we scan the scan abutments, and we scan the relations of both jaws. So we have the first scan with small amount of composite, and we have the final scan. And now we can assemble all of the scans, and we have the scan abutments, and we can have some kind of bridge in those relations. Mm-hmm.
So now you are making a temporary bridge and the normal procedure. Temporary bridge, wait 3 months, take it off, make corrections, make
exactly.
a permanent now, bridge.
What do you have now? Now you have immediate loading. After immediate loading, you have maximum 3-4 days to make some kind of bridge and assemble, screw the bridge into the implants. Mm-hmm. And then you need to wait 3-4 months before the next steps, before the osteointegration is completed or in some way complete. It's a case that we're still working on. Those pictures, those videos are from, I think, the last month. So we don't have the the provisional bridge, but it's something that we do a lot of times, and I think we already show some kind of cases with this type of technique. Mm-hmm. When you first of all take relations and you connect all the scan abutments with composite material, but this time we also took a video to show the how easy it can be done. What do you need to have and what do you need to do to get to the provisional bridge that you want to have?
Don't forget to send us the rest of the case.
Yeah, I'll try. You need to remind me.
I will. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
And thank you for being here today. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and follow us to stay tuned up to date. Have a great day, and thank you.